What's up? Booyah! I'm back with another drunk reaction, and today I'm drinking fireballs I offered him. I just realized something. I'm recording this obviously before Christmas because you can see the Christmas candle here. I don't know if it's a very good shot, like you can tell here, but that's Santa Claus on the front of the candle there. And I realized this isn't dropping until January 18th, so it's well past Christmas, like 3 weeks past Christmas. And usually this is about the time that 3 weeks past, no, the hell, 4 weeks past Christmas, right? 3 weeks into the new year. This is about the time you start looking at your neighbors like, you ever going to take your fucking Christmas decorations down, motherfucker? Because you're negligent. Y'all just negligent. You know, you ever, and so, yeah, this is starting to get negligent here, right? You know, but see, like, this is my dad's Christmas candle. And what happened was there was a candle holder that would hold two candles in his living room. And one of the candles broke, you know, so that's why I don't have the full candle holder over here. I just have one of the candles. But the other candle, you know, and so for 11 months out of the year, he would actually turn the candle around so it just looked like he had two white candles in his living room. And then once we hit December, he would turn it back around to reveal Santa Claus, right? So what I'm going to do, for as long as I'm doing reactions while it's still in December, I'll just have the candle turned around so I'm not like one of those neighbors like, really? Really? You still got your Christmas decorations up, you lazy fat bastard? Basically, though, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to get really far ahead so that I'm never missing, like, any uploads. I always want my videos to premiere 9 a.m. in the morning. Like, the first, you know, whatever the first video of the day is, premiere at 9 a.m. in the morning. And I was getting to a point where I was, like, you know, exporting at 8:30 and shit, and it wouldn't be time, and I'd be late. It'd be 9:15, 9:20, 9:30 and shit. It just fucking irritates me, man. So I'm trying to get way ahead so that I have time to edit all this shit so that I can, you know, have scheduled, you know, have a bunch of shit scheduled so that I, you know, just try to be a little more professional. But, you know, sometimes it can put me like where I'm looking like negligent as hell with my Christmas decorations. So anyway, I don't know how many people noticed that for the previous videos. Probably not many. But we ain't here to talk about Christmas decorations. We're here for Better Call Saul. Let's get into this shit.
1967, but I think it'll work.
Just a second.
This must have been when he first started going crazy.
Excellent. Thank you.
They like to play with their expectations. I think this is not before he went crazy, or when he was going crazy. This is something else entirely. The whole thing with the ring threw me. You know, he's trying to, I think he's going to pop the question or some shit. I don't know, man. Got enough goddamn candles?
Rebecca, the deadbeat at 512 San Cristobal hasn't been paying his bills. And of course, I'm
215.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. That's where Chuck got the idea. Jimmy got the idea. I like that. I like that a lot.
This place is the same. I mean, I would have thought you'd change things up, move things around.
He ain't changing shit.
You said we'll never finish this.
It's working. Of course, we know it doesn't ultimately work. I wonder what blows it.
I hate that thing. I feel like I'm on a leash. Oh. I'm sorry.
Oh, shit.
Oh, got it. I will make sure that...
Yeah, that's right. Get really close to him with that fucking thing.
Whenever you okay. All
right, he can just go up and excuse himself, but then he's got to go to the bathroom, right? Yeah, that's what I was saying. That's what I would have done. As soon as it rang, I would have said, excuse me, I'm going to use the bathroom. Go ahead. Jesus Christ, man.
It is incredibly bad manners to answer
a cell phone. Really, dude? Really? Bye. Goodbye.
I'm sorry. I didn't know that you felt that way. I didn't mean to offend you.
Jesus fucking Christ, man.
I may have overreacted. It was very abrupt.
No, I understand.
Yeah, I understand. I'm getting the fuck out of here. Jesus Christ, man. Chuck's a dick. He's a dick. I mean, all he had to fucking do, man, was just go upstairs and go to the bathroom.
Please let me...
No, really. A cab is the easiest.
Yeah. I mean, like...
You gotta do something. You can't let her leave like this. Just tell...
I mean, yeah, it's Monday morning quarterback. I mean, like, as soon as the phone rang, I'd be like, excuse me, I gotta go to the bathroom. And just fucking fuck off for 10 minutes. Like, nobody would think anything of that, man. Like, are you shitting me? It was untenable. There's no way long-term you could have managed that, man. Just, you know. The fuck you looking at?
Yeah, just because you don't see swinging dicks doesn't mean you can't tell a boy fish from a girl fish. Oh, yeah, see, now I can see the lipstick.
He's a dick.
He's not a piece of fur. I'm guessing our friend didn't refer you to me to get ichthyological advice.
Whatever the fuck that is.
I'm not talking some teenager taking a 5-finger discount of string cheese at the Stop and Shop. I need highly skilled, high-end, discreet, real pro.
You gotta fit him in a tight space?
I don't think so. I got just a guy then.
Oh, okay, so he's a fat ass. Gotcha. Oh, don't tell. Oh, Hugh! It's gonna be Hugh! That dude, man. That big motherfucker. Like, when he be picking motherfuckers' pockets, you never know. And with this size, it's like unbelievable, man. That's totally who the fuck it's gonna be.
Kim, I knew you were good, but I didn't know you were this good.
Oh, I'm glad you're happy.
We couldn't have done it without you, Ann. I hope you realize this means a whole lot more coming your way.
If you are not comfortable staying with me, we can discuss options.
I mean, she just killed in that meeting, so I don't think...
If there's one thing I cannot abide, it's a man who won't own up to his mistakes.
Fantastic.
Miguel is slinging. He's not going to screw me out of the best outside.
You're goddamn right.
And now the most important thing, dinner.
Dinner, you goddamn right. That's his most important thing. Thank you, sir.
This is about PR.
Yep.
We lost a client. That happened because while you were incapacitated, your brother accessed documents that should have been secured at HHM.
He's got a point.
What Jimmy deserves disbarment, not some slap on the wrist.
Now, and just like Jimmy, his emotions cloud his judgment. And this is
secret. Let justice be done, though the heavens fall.
Sorry to keep... We'll see, motherfucker.
You'll understand James McGill is an asset to our legal community. And he should remain a full member of it in good standing. Thank you.
Can it be in mediocre standing? Because I feel like that's where his place really is.
Nepotism. Your firm is Hamlin, Hamlin, and McGill, right? Who's the other Hamlin?
My father.
Booyah.
Which partner is the most concerned with nepotism?
Fantastic.
So Jimmy,
40 minutes less to check.
Shit. Okay, keep me posted.
I wonder what the hell that's about. Like, they keep me mystified on the show. I love it. I really do love it. I love not being able to know what's going on.
In some ways, I can say I admire him.
F you. You know, I cuss often, right? So when I say F you, that's a special kind of insult. Because I can totally say fuck you, right? F you is like, somehow it's above fuck you to me. Because I never say F you, right? It's like when I'm really fucking angry, but I'm trying to contain my emotions, it'd be like, F you, instead of fuck you, right? Because fuck you, like, you can say that all the time, right? That just rolls off my tongue. F you's the next level, you know?
Besides, it's your word against mine.
Well, this is awkward. There's you. There he is. What's up, motherfucker? What's up, motherfucker? Give me that shit. The best pickpocket ever, man. He definitely looks older, man. Unfortunately, you know, time hits us all in the head, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, that dude's an excellent pickpocket.
Did you state your name?
I bet.
Charles L. McGill?
Shit, pausing. Mark. I had to pause again. Like, I've been doing this a lot, but like, this show's so complex. You gotta fucking, you really gotta like be, you need like an intermission to divine all this shit. I think what's going on with this whole pickpocket scenario is he put something in, he didn't take something out, right? I bet he put in a cell phone. That, and Chuck's gonna be sitting there for like a long time, for like maybe, you know, within sight for like 20 minutes, and then they'll call that cell phone. And it'll ring, and that'll show, first of all, he's not allergic to electricity, you know? So, because, like, he was sitting there, and they wasn't fucking with him. But then also, why has he got a cell phone, huh? What's up? You know, so, like, that'll make him look bad. I don't know how that really helps your case too much, but, like, it can't be good for him, you know, make it seem like this is all some bullshit. Or it has something to do with those photographs. It's one or the other. Because they still haven't explained why he needed Mike to take those photographs. They have a very serious shenanigan planned here, man. But that's what I predict. He put something in, he didn't take something out.
Going to continue. It will extend you the same latitude on cross, Miss Wexler.
Excellent. Which is what she wanted, I'm sure.
Sustained. We just need to hear what happened, Mr. McGill.
I apologize. I recorded my brother.
You should know better, Chuck. You're supposed to be the best lawyer in this fucking state.
You say that you as EHS, electromagnetic hypersensitivity. I describe it as an acute allergy to electromagnetism.
It's not a common condition, is it?
I know, it sounds strange. I do. But
ring, years ago, ring.
But you admit, would you say that your illness affects your ability to think clearly?
No, it affects me physically. It causes me great pain.
However, physical pain affects what you think, though. You know, thank what's you. Up?
Mr. McGill, I have only one more question for you.
Why are you such a dick?
Thank you, Mr. McGill.
Ring. God, I wish it. I hope there's a cell phone in here. And I hope it rings.
I'm sorry, my co-counsel and I need a moment to confer.
Please be brief, counselor.
Oh, they're bringing in Rebecca. That's why they were talking about flights and all that shit. Here she is. Gotcha. Holy shit. I still don't know what purpose this serves, but it definitely rattles him. I was even wondering if she was even alive, man. That was an open question. The fuck you doing here?
Chuck, I wish you told me.
Oh, shit.
I can't believe you sent me pictures of the house. Chuck, my God.
That's what the pictures
Why
are for.
Why didn't you tell me?
I don't want your shitty snacks. This water's fine.
You know, she's going to hate you when this is over. Yep.
Yeah, I think that ship has sailed on that one. Every scene has been about Jimmy, right? We haven't had any, like, Mike in this episode, right?
We did promise the defense some leeway.
Yep, exactly. That's come back to haunt your ass.
Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Split me apart at the seams like a murderer confessing on an episode of Perry Mason.
It's going to be something like that.
I'm sorry to disappoint you, Jimmy.
They see how paranoid he is about Jimmy. Thanks,
Have
Jimmy's...
I answered your questions to your satisfaction? Do you have anything else?
Yeah, motherfucker. Let me call your cell phone.
I do. Panel for their accommodation here today. I can handle this fine.
She's going to call it.
Could you reach into your breast pocket and tell me what's there?
Oh, shit.
What now?
The battery! Yes!
Mr. Chairman, please. He'll testify he planted this fully charged battery on you over an hour and a half ago. An hour and 43 minutes. Thank you,
Busted!
Mr. Babineau.
What's up?
No, it's a trick. Enough is enough. I submit that Mr. McGill's mental illness is a non-issue. If he was
mental illness,
it wouldn't take away from the fact that the defendant...
I am not crazy!
What's
I'm
up?
I'm not crazy. I just couldn't prove it.
Just like a Perry Mason confession.
He got that idiot ever since he was 9. Always the same. Couldn't keep his hands out of the cash drawer. But not our Jimmy. Couldn't be precious Jimmy.
God, this is amazing. This is better than you can't handle the truth.
And he gets to be a lawyer?
This is fucking... This is incredible. I love this.
I should have stopped him when I had the chance.
Holy shit, man. This is amazing.
You have to stop him.
What's up? Booyah! Boom! I got a full Woody right now. What's up? Pwned, bitch.
I apologize.
He even mocked that whole, like, Perry Mason thought. Confession. He fucking fell. He's a fish. He'd be mounted on the wall.
Got carried away.
Oh, now you the camera's pulling back. Nah, man. I ain't got shit.
No. Nothing further.
Neither one of them, they're both awesome on their own, but whenever they go up against each other, they just lose all rationality, man. Like, their emotions just get carried away in both cases, Beth. I thought it was just Jimmy's emotions for Chuck. It's the other way around, too, man. Oh, my. No, man. God damn it, man. I got shit to do today, man. I don't have time to watch another one, but I'm going to fucking have to, man, because, like, we can't leave it like that. We cannot leave it like that. I'm running out of booze and shit. God damn, that was fucking awesome. Oh my God, that was incredible. All right, that was just, like I said, you know, the whole thing with the Few Good Men, Jack Nicholson did that monologue perfectly. Perfectly, pitch perfect. Didn't drop a line. And yeah, I know personally how easy it is to drop a line from a monologue, man. I fucking know. Believe me. Did not drop a line. He did it 7 straight times. He even did it when it was Tom Cruise's, you know, the camera's on Tom Cruise as his solo shot. And you can really just read off the page if you want to, right? He did it perfectly for that. And a lot of times, like, you know, he's done. He can go to his trailer and you get a reader to do that side, right? No, he did it perfectly. 7 fucking times in a row. Like, this was on par with that. And you notice, like, by the way, there was no cuts. It was a one shot. And he fucking nailed it in a one shot, man. That's fucking difficult, man. Like, I'm telling him, like, that shit's not easy, man. Like, you know, because if you have, like, yeah, say 400 or 500 words you gotta say, right, to not drop a single word. Now, we don't know, maybe he did drop a line, like, we don't know that, right? But I'm just saying, like, I could talk about this shit all day. I'm just saying, that was fucking awesome. Wonderful. And this dude started as a fucking comedy actor. I just found out yesterday, because maybe it's today, I don't know. But he was on Laverne and Shirley as, like, you know their two buddies, Lenny and Squiggy or something like that. He played Lenny, and the guy who played Squiggy just died, and he was tweeting about it, you know. I didn't know he was that dude from Laverne and Shirley. I had no fucking idea. I never made the connection, you know? That was him looking young as fuck, man. Anyway, man, this is getting too long.